This is the Singapore Botanic Gardens Heritage Museum. It is housed in Holtham Hall and named after director Eric Holtham. Built in 1921, this building once served as a laboratory where the first experiments in orchid hybridization and breeding were carried out. The gardens was established in 1859 by the Singapore Agri-Horticultural Society. They acquired land at Tanglin, gifted by one of their founders, Whampoa Hoo Ah Kay, and the gardens was then laid out in the style of the English landscape movement. Many landmarks, including the Main Gate Road, Lawn E, and Bandstand Hill, remain today. In 1866, the gardens, then privately managed, fell into debt and was handed over to the colonial government to manage. When the number of visitors declined, the gardens introduced a zoo as an additional attraction that ran for 30 years. In the 1870s, the colonial government requested for qualified personnel from the Royal Botanic Gardens, Kew, to manage the expanding gardens in Singapore. James Merton was the first of many Kew-trained men who led the gardens in setting up a plant exchange system, the Singapore Herbarium and Library of Botany and Horticulture. Henry Nicholas Ridley then became the garden's first director in 1888. He accelerated the botanical studies on Malayan flora and led the trialing of economic crops for commercial suitability in the region. Director E.J.H. Connor pioneered the study on canopy ecology and was best remembered to have recruited two macaques to pick seeds, fruits, ferns, and leaves from the treetops as high as 50 meters. During the Japanese occupation, Connor was instrumental in preserving the botanical and scholarly collections in Singapore. The garden's research work resumed in 1955, and the operations of the gardens came to be managed by trained local staff. The School of Ornamental Horticulture was set up later in 1972 to train more locals for the horticulture industry, aiding in the tree planting movement and greening of Singapore. The orchid breeding program began in 1928 as attention was turned to taxonomic research, and this program led to the birth of Singapore's orchid export trade. Today, the orchid breeding and hybridization program has bred and registered more than 630 hybrids, many of which are part of the VIP orchid naming program. These orchids can be seen within the National Orchid Garden. More than 15 crops were brought to the Singapore Botanic Gardens to be trialed and studied for their economic value for crop plantations in the region. 1879 marked the beginning of the garden's evolution from a park for leisure to a center of scientific experimentation and plant exchange. Rubber was one of the most notable successes, aided by Director Ridley, who was known as Mad or Rubber Ridley. He was invested in finding the commercial value of rubber trees, developing good agricultural practices, and refining latex harvesting methods. Ridley tirelessly promoted rubber, carrying rubber seeds in his pockets to distribute to those who were willing to try. Those who jumped on the bandwagon enjoyed the success of the global increase in demand for rubber in the early 1900s. The Singapore Botanic Gardens is the first tropical botanic garden on the UNESCO World Heritage List. Today, the Singapore Botanic Gardens is a popular spot for pre-wedding photos, picnics, and open-air stage concerts. Come and discover the garden's rich history for yourself.